Welcome back to Movie Recap. Today I'm gonna show you a 2011 South Korean war film called, Mai Wei. Spoiler ahead. Seat back, relax and enjoy. The film opens with a brief scene of Kim Jun-sik overtaking other runners in the Olympics. The film actually starts with Tatsuo's family arriving in Gyeongsang, Korea. While heading there in a car, the Japanese Tatsuo encounters the Korean Kim Jun-sik running outside toward his family. After a brief introduction between Tatsuo's and Kim Jun-sik's family, the smug Tatsuo proclaims that he is the fastest runner in Tokyo. Because of this, Kim Jun-sik challenges the newly arrived Tatsuo. While they are running, the scene transitions to their teams. The two are now fierce competitors, with each of them winning for their respective nations. However, Tatsuo seems to have the edge over Kim Jun-sik. During a celebration of Tatsuo's latest achievement, Kim Jun-sik's father unknowingly delivers a bomb to Tatsuo's grandfather, killing his grandfather in the process. This event sours the relationship between Tatsuo and Kim Jun-sik, as Tatsuo accuses Kim Jun-sik's father of killing his grandfather. Afterward, Kim Jun-sik, his sister, and his recently tortured father are kicked out of Tatsuo's house, with Tatsuo threatening Kim Jun-sik never to return. The family then sees a celebratory announcement about a Korean that has recently won the gold medal, stirring some motivation inside Kim Jun-sik. The film jumps to 1938. Kim Jun-sik now works as a rickshaw runner, and his customer challenges him to run as fast as he can. If they arrive at the place within 30 minutes, the fee will be doubled. Meanwhile, Tatsuo announces to the press that no more Koreans will compete in marathons, proclaiming that he will set a new record himself for Japan. After a quick run, Kim Jun-sik and his customer arrive at the place, with the customer telling Kim that he is quite a runner. The customer is actually Son Ki-chung, the Korean gold medalist. Son Ki-chung then heads inside, revealing that he is going to where Tatsuo is. There, Son tells the audience that the announcement to ban Koreans from racing is unjust, and that it will be boring to see Tatsuo but not Kim. Just then, Kim Jun-sik is being pushed by his friend toward the event to prove that his customer earlier is indeed the famous Son Ki-chung. However, the audience immediately recognizes Kim, and he is pushed further to where Son and Tatsuo are. There, Kim tells the inquiring audience that he will be grateful to enter the race. Afterward, Tatsuo is offered by his father to study in Berlin, but Tatsuo refuses, citing that sports is much more important than his studies. Even after his father admonishes him for refusing to be a doctor, Tatsuo remains stubborn in his wishes to stay for his dead grandfather's sake. Meanwhile, Eun-soo, Kim Jun-sik's sister, tells Kim that he should enter the tryouts. Kim's friend, Lee Jong-dae, has a crush on Eun-soo, who gives her a hairpin, telling her that she's the prettiest woman in all of Asia. Outside the house, while gathering wood, Kim is visited by Son. Son then gives him an Olympic tryouts form. Because of this, Lee celebrates by carrying Kim's father on his back and encouraging the neighbors that Korea's best marathoner is now competing. In the next scene, the race finally begins. A Japanese racer almost trips Kim in the ensuing race, but he manages to dodge it. Eventually, Kim wins the marathon, causing the Korean population to celebrate proudly. However, the announcer heralds Tatsuo as the winner, with Kim being disqualified for apparently cheating earlier. Because of this, Kim immediately heads to the judges to speak his mind. This result and the sight of Kim and Lee being violently suppressed causes uproar with the Korean population, eventually leading to a riot. While this is happening, Tatsuo just shamefully stands there in silence. Afterward, the rioters, as punishment, are forcibly drafted to the Imperial Army of Japan. They are promptly taken to the battlefield on a train, to the Battle of Namhan. There, they find themselves retreating against the much stronger Soviets. After retreating, they gather water in a ruined town. There, they encounter another enemy, a Chinese sniper that is actually a woman named Shirai. After managing to fight her off, Kim gets shocked to see that she is a woman. After capturing Shirai, the Korean men then deliver her to the Japanese. However, instead of praising them, the Japanese punish them because of the Japanese casualties. Simultaneously, the Japanese interrogate and torture Shirai. This is all stopped when the colonel, who is fair to Koreans, enters and orders the whole thing to stop. That night, Kim runs around the camp. He also sees Shirai being transferred to her cell. The following day, the company runs to greet a newly arrived colonel. The newly arrived colonel is actually Tatsuo. Tatsuo then tells the colonel that he is demoted to a private for ordering a shameful retreat. He is also to commit harakiri, who prove loyalty to the emperor. After the colonel's death, Tatsuo then announces that he will destroy Soviet tanks. He also briefly sees Kim from the soldiers lined up. That night, Tatsuo orders his men to have a special suicide unit to demolish the Soviet tanks. At the same time, Kim returns Shirai's journal and fixed picture to her, making Shirai happy. Kim then tells her that he also has a sister like her back home. After Kim leaves, Shirai thanks her, but Kim does not understand. The following day, the company constructs a bridge in the Kokin River. Kim asks Lee what Shirai said last night, and Lee tells him that it means thank you, making Kim smile. Just then, Tatsuo arrives, and one of Kim's fellow soldiers catches a fish in the river because he is hungry. Because of this, that night, Tatsuo punishes Kim's squad by taking all of their food and other things, including Kim's running shoes that were given to him by his father. Kim attempts to take back the shoes despite being beaten by the officers, but to no avail, the shoes are still burned. In the next scene, the bridge is finally constructed. However, the sadistic Japanese officer removes the screw so that Kim's squad would be punished. Sure enough, the squad is punished by Tatsuo. The cruel punishment is for the squad to carry the plank back to base while the sadistic officer stands above them. That night, Lee and Kim are among the soldiers chosen for the upcoming 50-man suicide special unit. Kim refuses to take part in the operation. Tatsuo then personally punishes Kim for disobeying his order, beating him in the chest with the butt of a rifle. However, despite the repeated beating, Kim returns to his position, much to the anger of Tatsuo. Finally, Kim collapses from his injury. The frustrated Tatsuo orders his execution tomorrow along with other prisoners. Kim is then put in the same cell as Shirai, where she tells Kim that the only thing she regrets is not being able to kill more Japanese. That same night, Kim's buddies break out Kim and Shirai from their cells. After only barely escaping from camp, Kim and the others run to the south, toward the river, to take a boat out there. However, upon reaching the river, Kim sees the incoming Soviet tanks. Kim then decides to let the boat drift away with his friends while he returns to the camp. Running back, Kim encounters a Soviet plane. Afterward, Shirai comes back for Kim and promptly shoots the plane. She manages to shoot the plane with her expert marksmanship, but she gets shot in the process. Kim then runs to Shirai, telling her, "Thank you," in Chinese before Shirai dies in his arms. Kim runs back to the base, where he sees Tatsuo and the army moving in his direction. Kim waves at them to stop because the Soviet is attacking. Tatsuo is about to shoot him when he sees tanks behind Kim, making the army change their tactics. While running back, Kim gets knocked out by an explosion. The Japanese, on the other hand, managed at first to halt the Soviets' movement. When Kim wakes up, he sees the dismal state of things surrounding him. He then attempts to save one of his friends from the sadistic Japanese officer forcing his friend to commit a suicide charge. However, Kim's friend still died when his legs got run over by a tank. Tatsuo relentlessly tries to fight the Soviet, but the enemy arrives with more tanks. Finding the situation futile, some men retreat, but Tatsuo shoots them for doing this. Kim confronts Tatsuo, telling him to order the retreat. But Tatsuo is stubborn in his beliefs, even dragging Kim toward the Soviets with a suicide bomb. However, they get flung into the air by a Soviet tank's cannon. In the next scene, Tatsuo, Kim, and other soldiers are now prisoners of war being transferred to a Soviet labor camp in Perm. Upon arriving, Tatsuo is commanded to step on the Japanese flag to show they will follow the Soviets, but Tatsuo retains his nationalist stubbornness. Because of this, he gets beaten by rifles and tied to a post as punishment. The rest of the soldiers are lined up again in another area of the camp. There, Kim sees his friends again, but Lee is missing. It turns out that Lee is their work leader, who now goes by the name Anton. After briefly telling the prisoners about what they will be doing, Kim and Lee meet again in a joyous reunion. The sadistic Japanese officer mockingly greets Lee, but Lee violently retaliates because he now has power over him, beating him harshly with a rifle. Kim and other prisoners notice that Lee has become power drunk. That night, Tatsuo is returned to their barracks. Lee arrives as well, telling his former superior officer to get out of his sight. The other Japanese want to save Tatsuo by warming him up, and Lee allows it after mocking Tatsuo. Lee then leads Kim outside the barracks. They talk near the incinerators. Lee tells Kim that he likes it here because no Japanese can insult him here. He then tells Kim that he's not returning to Korea even though he misses Unsu. The next day, a newly recovered Tatsuo shouts at the prisoners to stand for the emperor. Kim does not stand, which makes Tatsuo angry. Kim reminds him that he and other Koreans were unjustly forced to become imperial soldiers, adding that Tatsuo should commit harakiri. This further angers Tatsuo, who attacks Kim, causing the whole barracks to erupt. Because of this, the Russian forces the two to have a grudge match. After a tough battle, Kim emerges victorious between the two, but he chooses to spare Tatsuo. As punishment, they are both tied outside. In the next scene, one of Kim's friends has frostbite on his feet. Because of this, he is deemed unfit for work, and so he will be executed. Another one of Kim's friends is caught by Lee in the storage room, who gives him to the Soviets despite being his friend. That same night, Kim's friend is executed by hanging for stealing food, and Lee is the one to deliver him to the platform, proving that his loyalty is now to the Soviets. Kim confronts Lee afterward, but Lee tells him that he is now Anton. In the next scene, the Russian tells Tatsuo that the Japanese refused to exchange prisoners of war because they were busy fighting the Americans. Tatsuo does not believe this, of course. Afterward, Tatsuo witnesses Kim running outside the barracks despite the wintry cold. The following day, a riot among the prisoners erupted after the death of a Japanese prisoner in the hands of Lee. Tatsuo and Kim attack Lee, resulting in an all-out brawl. Because of this, those who started the riot are to be executed immediately. Just as Kim and Tatsuo are to be executed, a siren goes off, and trucks arrive at the camp. The Russian announces that Germany has just declared war against the Soviets and that the prisoners can now convert as Soviet soldiers. Those who refuse are shot immediately. Lee requests that Kim and Tatsuo are converted as well, thereby stopping their executions. Tatsuo hesitates to wear the uniform because he is loyal to his nation, but he eventually wears it out of necessity. In the next scene, they are promptly delivered to Zetovsk. There, they were given guns and ammo by the Soviets. After that, they are funneled to a sure massacre. In the ensuing chaos, Kim saves Tatsuo from cannon fire. Tatsuo witnesses how the Soviets kill those who retreat, much like him earlier. On the other hand, Kim witnesses Lee's death, who gives him Unsu's picture. Lee then warns him to stay down before dying himself. After the battle, Tatsuo sees Kim scavenging German uniforms, with Kim telling him that he's heading to German territory. The two embark on a mountain climb. That night, Tatsuo asks Kim why he never killed him, but Kim never gives an answer. After a long walk, they finally reach the outskirts of a town. Just as Kim runs toward the town, Tatsuo collapses behind him. Because of this, Kim carries Tatsuo down the mountain toward the town. The town is actually abandoned, and so Kim lays Tatsuo down to search for his medicine. However, he comes across a group of Germans. He asks for their help, telling them that he is Japanese, but he gets arrested, leaving Tatsuo behind. The film then cuts to 3 years later. A group of German soldiers are being transported to Normandy, and one of them is Tatsuo. While having lunch there, Tatsuo misrecognizes someone as Kim. A German then tells him to stop looking for his Korean friend. After finishing a day's work fortifying Normandy, Tatsuo sees someone running by the shore, Kim. However, Kim is now deaf from his left ear, which is from when he saved Tatsuo. Afterward, Tatsuo and Kim play a game of soccer with other soldiers during their break time. In the next scene, the German officer tells the soldiers that they will be transferred to another place to guard against an invasion. Because of this, Tatsuo, after getting information from another soldier, tells Kim that they will escape instead to Cherbourg to take a ship back home. That night, while sneaking out, the Americans launch a surprise air raid, and the two get separated again. While the invasion of Normandy is underway, they finally meet again inside a pillbox, but a German officer forces them to man the machine gun. Having no choice, they fire against the swarm of soldiers underneath. As the Allies climb to the pillbox, the two manage to escape barely. After finding a way out of the trenches, the two run away from the battlefield. After a brief successful run, the two are stopped by an explosion, with Kim bleeding hard in his chest. He then instructs Tatsuo to take his identity, that he is a Korean forced to fight for the Germans. Kim adds that, although he did not achieve his dreams, he has no regrets. Afterward, Kim dies, with Tatsuo mourning by his side as Allied forces come closing in. The film ends with Tatsuo, now running as Kim Jun-sik, somehow continuing and fulfilling Kim's dream. Subscribe for more videos like this to help the channel out. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.